welcome to your yoga practice. Today we are going to take a pause to get into our hips, and we'll start pretty intense. And you're welcome to have blocks to cushion yourself along the way. A pillow might work if you have like a giant pillow pet. That might help as well, but we'll start low to the ground and we'll make our way towards a goddess pose where we really get to work on strengthening our hips and getting them super open. So let's get started. So let's take the soles of our feet together, knees out wide, and allow the outsides of your feet to really touch and press into each other. And that will open up the soles of your feet, kind of like a book. And if you want, you can go ahead and start taking your thumbs, if you're okay touching your feet, and just rub that arch of your foot. There's a lot of almost like gristle that you feel here, and it can feel really nice to give yourself a nice foot massage. And it also just makes this hip opening a lot more gentle and a lot more inviting for your body. A lot of us store a lot of tension in our hips, and some people believe that emotions even get stored there. So sometimes there's a lot of resistance to opening your hips. And if you do any type of other exercise like running, weightlifting, your hips can be very, very, very stiff. So taking the time to open them is good. All right. Now we'll also get into our side body. So extend extend the right leg off to the right, and then you can keep this left foot like this. You can also tuck the left leg behind you, whatever works. I'm going to keep it like this just because that's how I like to do it. And bring your right hand to your left leg. Reach your left arm up and over, and you can stay here. Or if you can reach the foot, you can keep on sending that arm all the way to the foot. And if you have your foot tucked like this, you can reach underneath your body, grab the heel. Oh, and then find a nice side bend along with this hip opener. So just doing some nice, yummy, feel good stretches to get into our bodies, to see what's open, and then come out of it. Extend the left leg out and then bring the right leg in. You can leave your leg here, or you can tuck that heel behind you, whatever feels better. And then take your left hand to your right knee and then start to side bend, taking it as far as you would like. Maybe even tucking that left arm under, grabbing the heel, and then reaching that foot. Being gentle with yourself here. Allowing your body to find an opening. Really feeling into this body of yours. And then coming up. Oh, all right. Take a nice fire log pose. So take your right leg and bring that shin parallel to the mat in front of you. And then your left leg is going to go over. So left knee will stack over right ankle. Left ankle will stack over right knee. And for a lot of us, our knees all the way up here. So that's a good place if you want to stick like a pillow right there. It can be really comforting. Or a block can work too. Be sure to keep your feet nice and flexed. If you don't have much room there, you don't need to stick anything there. And maybe the reason that you use your pillow, if you want to use one, is to come forward so that we really get into those nice and open hips. So we'll breathe here for a few breaths, and then we will get into the other side. Is taking the time to open these hips of ours. Keeping our legs active. So this can be kind of more yin-like since we are staying in the pose. And I also want you to engage your lower body. So flex those feet. squeeze your legs together like a sandwich. And that will protect your joints a whole lot. All right, so go ahead and widen your legs. This time, your left leg will go down first. So left shin is parallel to the edge of the mat. Flex the left foot and then lay that right shin over. So right ankle over the left knee, right knee over the left ankle. And remember, if this knee, the top knee, is super elevated, stick a pillow under, stick a block under. A pillow feels a lot nicer because then you don't have something hard against your ankle. So it just feels really nice. Blankets work too. You know, just wedge something there if that feels good. And then feel free to use a pillow to come over so that way you can lean forward but still have a nice soft cushion there. Maybe sway side to side. Be sure to keep those feet flexed. That will focus on strengthening the knees and keeping them safe in this pose. Remember to back off if you feel any sharp pain. That is never a good sign, ever. Come up when you're ready. All right. And then unravel the legs, open them up, give them a little shake. Ooh, feels good actually. Feels really nice. Just felt all this blood rushing on my legs. Maybe you felt something very similar. All right, so come to stand. However you want to get there, come to stand up. And then bring your feet nice and wide. And at first, we're going to take a wide-legged forward fold. So keep your feet parallel to each other. So either the insides of your feet are parallel or maybe you parallel the outsides of your feet so that the toes turn in just slightly. Bring your hands to your hips, bring your chest up, look up slightly on an inhale, and then exhale, hinging over your legs. Your legs are super strong. And reach your hands to the mat. Allow your upper body to descend. Shake out your head. Press into your feet. Strengthen those legs. And then bring your hands under your chest, halfway lift. You step back a little bit so don't move out of the camera. Bring the heels in, toes out, and start to bend the knees. Coming into a deep squat with wide legs. Bring your hands above your knees. And now we're in a goddess squat, but our hands are supported. We'll take a few dips. So dip the right shoulder down, left shoulder goes back. Come back up. Left shoulder down, right shoulder back. Do it again. Coming through center. Right shoulder dips. Inhale through center. Left shoulder dips. And then coming up. And then starting. I just fell over. Starting to come up. Bring your hands to heart center. It happens. Pressing into your feet. And go ahead and straighten your legs. And we'll go into it in just a moment. That way we're not exhausting our legs too quickly. Go ahead and sit down into your goddess pose. Trying to keep your body nice and straight up and down. And maybe you lift up your right heel, lower it down. Lift up your left heel, lower it down. Maybe you keep alternating or you try to lift both heels up. Apparently my balance today in this pose isn't great. So if I fall over, we'll laugh together. So hold here, maybe dipping down a little bit more. Breathing. And then heels down, straighten the legs, parallel the feet, and then come down, forward folding over these legs. Breathing here. And then taking the hands underneath your chest again. And then we're gonna lunge into the right knee. So you'll see that I'm pointing the right toes out. I'm also pointing the left toes out. And I'm starting to bend the right knee down. and I'm lifting the left toes up. And you can definitely be on the right toes. Some people's heels just don't come down. It's an Achilles thing. Nothing's wrong with you if that happens. And then look over at that left foot. The toes should be flexed. And then come back up through your wide-legged forward fold. Point the toes out and then start coming towards that left leg. Right toes are up. And then let's go side to side. So coming through center and then coming into that deep lunge on the right side. It's called Skandasana or Silver Surfer. Some people call it that. Coming through wide-legged forward fold and then into your Skandasana on the left. You can use your hands. Maybe you challenge yourself by bringing hands to heart center. And then coming side to side like that. And you can stay much higher if you want. So it'll look more like this, like going from extended side angle to extended side angle. Or you can bring it deeper. It's just a lot more on your knees. All right. When you're ready, come back into a wide-legged forward fold. Come to a halfway lift on your inhale. Exhale, hands to hips. Inhale all the way up. Heel toe the feet together. And then come to a seat. Whew. Coming to a nice easy seat. Noticing how open the hips are. How activated your legs are. Taking time to breathe here before you continue on with your day. Bring your hands to heart center. Thank you so much for practicing with me today. I hope that you enjoyed this short yoga pause. Please join me again soon for another yoga pause. Thank you and have a beautiful day. Bye.